And I really, it really hit me hard, and I've never forgotten the sacrifice that so many people have made. And so I've taken my civic duty seriously all these years. After I was served as the downtown manager in DeLand for many years, and I was proud that we won the national award for our downtown revitalization efforts, I ran for the city commission and served a term over there on the DeLand City Commission. But I, as we talked about, I've been working over here on the east side for the last 8 years, so I actually put my house for sale after my daughter graduated from DeLand High School a little over a year ago, and I've been trying to sell my house for over a year. It finally sold, and so I moved to Port Orange very recently, and so my next experience, I hope, is serving the people of District 28 in the House.
That's great. You'll be spending a lot of time in Tallahassee.
Yes.
How's that going to affect your job?
Well, what did we say about sacrifice? I think my boss is going to be sacrificing also. I'd like to think that, you know, I can still do the best I can to keep the home fires burning. But it's a sacrifice for your employer. And, you know, people, unless you're independently wealthy, you do need to have a job. And I think it's good that people are working people in the legislature, that they have a pulse on really what it takes to run a business down, you know, back at the ranch. And so, you know, I'll always have that, you know, to draw upon in the reality, you know. But also, you know, I work in an industry in healthcare that gives me some perspective on that important issue. I've also worked heavily in economic development. I want to work hard on job creation and getting this state back to work. It's important.
This is job creation. You just hit on something very close to my heart.
Yes.
Our governor says he wants to create jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And I know he's lost a lot of support because of some of the hard decisions he's made.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, I applaud some of the decisions he's made.
Right.
I think they've been wise. But here in our Volusia County,
mm-hmm.
I have an issue with the jobs. I have two issues.
Mm-hmm.
The first being is we have no control over illegal aliens taking American jobs.
And why did that happen, in your opinion? Why are they getting the jobs?
Well,
we've allowed it.
I'm blaming it on our local government.
Right, we've allowed it.
I'm blaming it, yes.
Mm-hmm.
As a matter of fact, I said to one of our council people here last year, year before last, I said, why can't we put in place a check and balance where if you're going to get a contract, or your contractor's license, or pull a permit on a job, why can't you be required to prove that the employees that you have are at least legal?
Right.
I don't care if they're Mexican or,
sure.
or where they're from,
yeah.
but at least be legal.
Right.
Oh, well, that's a federal issue. We can't address that. Baloney is a federal issue. That's a Volusia County issue.
It's an everywhere issue.
It's an everywhere issue, but it's an issue that would affect jobs right here in Volusia County and an awful lot of jobs.
Absolutely. Yep.
The second place I need to go for jobs, and this is one of the reasons I'd like to have Pam Bondi on here.
Mm-hmm.
We have organizations all over this county called code enforcement.
Yes.
For the most part, code enforcement are made up of the most arrogant,
mm-hmm.
pompous individuals
mm-hmm.
I've ever met.
Yep.
And I'm not blaming that, I'm not saying that for any county, for the county or the city, but in general, there are some very good people there, very dedicated people.
Yes.
But there are an awful lot of them that are not. I was told, well, we don't go out and we don't look for code violations. We only respond to complaints.
Mm-hmm.
That's a lie.
Yeah.
It's an absolute lie. I say, well, and part of the problem, well, we have, if you get a code violation, we have a code violation called in on you. Oh, really? Who called it in? Oh, it was anonymous.
Mm-hmm.
And if you call code enforcement, they will encourage you to file anonymously. If you would like to call in your complaint, baloney.
Yeah.
If you're a murderer, you have a right to file your accuser.
Mm-hmm. Good point.
All right.
Good point.
So we had one incident in our area, mm-hmm. here in Tomoka Farms, where there's a feed store down there. Someone called in a complaint about the way what he was selling and so forth. When push came to shove, we found out who filed the complaint. It was a woman living in Edgewater.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what right does she have to complain about a business in Tomoka Farms when she lives in Edgewater?
Yeah.
She stopped at the gas station and she bought some gas. If it's not a health and safety issue,
mm-hmm.
where I'm going with this, is code enforcement get off the backs of our local business people.
Mm-hmm.
Loosen up on the sign ordinances. Let the local business people breathe a little bit. As they get some breathing room, they'll hire more people. And again, here we got more jobs coming back into our county.
No question about it.
Can you do something about that in Tallahassee?
Well, code enforcement obviously has been a local issue, but you know, I can tell you my views on that because I have been a local official. You know, there's two things. One, you're talking about private property rights, which to me are very, very important. That's one of the things our country was founded upon.
Right.
Secondly, attitudes, cultural attitudes. Why do we accept people that work for us in government to have anything less than the highest, utmost respect for our businesses and our tax-paying citizens? I just cannot tolerate anyone in government or really anywhere in any service profession treating people with disrespect and disdain, and that's what you do get sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
I know there are a lot of proud employees that appreciate their jobs that are in city government, county government, state government. I understand that there certainly are, but you know, those few bad apples.
That's right.
We need to police that better and have better attitudes. It shouldn't be acceptable, because I know plenty of unemployed people that have, you know, a proper attitude towards serving, and you know, I think they would be thrilled to have one of those jobs, so I don't know why we tolerate it. So you know, as far as I'm concerned, you know, when I'm in a leadership position in Tallahassee, I'm gonna insist government employees must go through, if they can't, really they should have it within them to this,
yeah,
proper respect, you know, treat others the way you wish to be treated, you know.
I've seen some code enforcement officers out there that are so pompous,
mm-hmm.
that I just like to haul off and crack them.
Yeah.
But I will say this, and just for the audience, and you didn't know this, there is a federal no trespass law.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Most people don't know that.
Right. Mm-hmm.
No county, state official, whether it be health department, code,
mm-hmm.
enforcement, or anybody else,
mm-hmm.
is allowed on your property,
yeah,
under federal trespass law without,
right,
your consent.
That goes back to the Bill of Rights, actually.
Yeah,
yeah, it really does.
They you know, I've had them walk around behind houses,
yeah,
taking pictures of
mm-hmm.
things, and then hitting these people with fines, outrageous fines,
mm-hmm.
and it's just ludicrous.
Mm-hmm.
And again, but going back to the businesses, give these people some breathing,
yes,
room.
Yes, absolutely. The more the better. Sometimes I think these economic development departments that we start up around here,
yeah,
are more of a business prevention unit,
mm-hmm.
because they are so heavy-handed on businesses and so adding to so many regulations that, you know, like you said, you're so busy putting out all these fires, you don't have time to look at your business plan and how am I going to expand, how... Mm-hmm. Shouldn't they be working to help us expand the current businesses?
Absolutely.
You know, to me, start with that. You know, I'm all for bringing in new business. That's great.
Right.
But what about these people who have been tried and true and invested in our areas all this time?
Mm-hmm.
Shouldn't we be helping them out, you know, a little bit?
We've got businesses,
you know,
going out of business right and left all over this
we
county.
We lost over, I think it's about 5,000 businesses since 2008. That's huge.
Yes.
Have you noticed the size of our telephone book in this area has gone from about this to this?
No,
that
I
tells you right there.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, look at the number of business licenses that are defunct now,
yeah,
and aren't just this county. That, if that's happening in 67 counties, Eddie, this is bad.
I know more people out of work than I know that are working.
I know a lot of people out of work, and it is very tough out there, very tough.
And something else where we ought to take a stand I've gotten a couple phone calls from different companies, and I say to the person on the other end of the line, where are you calling from? Manila.
Yeah.
India. You know what?
Yeah.
I don't want to deal with that company.
Yeah. Yep.
Because that company is an American company, so supposedly, who's taking American jobs and sending them overseas. I will not deal with these companies.
Good for you. And you know, my boss, who's a physician, emergency physician, who I said we have this billing company where we have 150 employees, we have been solicited many times by these overseas coding companies mm-hmm. that will do the medical codes. And they'll do it for a lot cheaper. We will not do it. And I applaud my boss for taking that stand. It costs him more to do that, but he is absolutely dedicated to keeping Americans employed and our local people employed. And we need more of that. You know, that should be rewarded.
Yes, it should. Yes, it should.
So
we've got to get our American people, our Volusia County citizens, mm-hmm. back to work.
And we need to buy American. If we just insist on buying American, it's hard to do.
It's hard to do.
But I'm saying if we made a concerted effort, even just trying harder than we're trying, it would bring jobs back. Because we are a huge population in the U.S. and in our state. We could definitely have an impact if, you know, I mean, just the I call them the keyboard warriors that are out there sending emails out to everybody. If they jumped on that and encouraged everyone to really concertedly buy American and support these local businesses that are hiring locally, that's important.
Local legislators have got to do something about that, something you're going to have to look at.
Mm-hmm.
Because we let them go, we let them go, we let them go, we mm-hmm. let them get away with murder. This half hour went faster than the last one.
We're having too much fun, Eddie.
Too much fun.
This coffee clatch, I tell you.
Well, Maureen, it has really been a pleasure having you.
Thank you so much.
We've covered a lot of territory, and I hope we'll have you back again. My name is Eddie Colosimo. The show is Volusia County Issues. We're looking for sponsorship to keep the show on air. If you've enjoyed the show and you like what you see, give us a call. If you've got a business, give me a call. We could use some sponsorship to keep things going here, which we're going to, but your sponsorship would be help. We're looking forward to more people that can come in here and give us the right ideas and help. Sometimes we can set you straight.
Absolutely.
Tell you how we feel.
Yes.
Because this is Volusia County, USA. It's not Volusia County, Communist China. And as long as I'm breathing, we're going to keep it Volusia County, USA. Thank you very much.